Hey everyone, Dekosaur here. Recently, I've been on the lookout for a new laptop which got Intel latest Meteor Lake CPU, and given that I got other Samsung product, I wanted to complete the ecosystem with a premium laptop. So without giving it a second thought, I quickly grabbed the newly released Galaxy Book 4 Pro 360. Keep in mind, it's my first ever Samsung laptop, so I was extremely excited. However, unfortunately, my experience instead has been quite disappointing due to its poor performance and extremely high thermals. So in this video, I'll share what to expect from this laptop, and I hope it will be good for spreading awareness, because frankly saying, it's by far the worst out-of-the-box laptop I've ever tried. So let's get started first with the basics. Even when the system is an idle and the CPU clocks are quite down, yet the CPU package temperature hovers around 64 degrees, with a package power of just 6 watts. This alone shows that the issue isn't with Intel chip efficiency, but rather with the Galaxy Book cooling system, which struggles to manage heat even at a lower power consumption. And now all of a sudden, temperature can spike to 86 degrees without even any load on the system. Let me clarify that this isn't due to improper use. The laptop is placed on a cooling stand and positioned to avoid blocking intake vents. All Samsung and Windows updates are installed and CPU usage is pretty low, so software doesn't seem to be the cause of this behavior. I've also went ahead and removed all bloatware, leaving all the essential Samsung updates and drivers, and even got the latest Arc GPU driver. Now, Samsung recommends setting the performance mode to optimize for a balanced experience, so I'll be testing it first in Cinebench with both optimized and high performance modes, so let's go for it. And we got disappointing scores of 9,972 and 11,630, respectfully, for multi-core performance. If you look at the expected score with Intel 155H CPU, you will see that the Galaxy Book 4 is under of what's normal for what this chip is capable of. Temperature checks show that the CPU package reaches up to 101 degrees in optimized mode and 108 degrees in high performance mode, leading to thermal throttling and inconsistent benchmark scores, as you saw throughout the test how it was going up and down. Now, wondering if the laptop fares better with real-world gaming, I tested Cyberpunk 2077 at the lowest settings with Intel Xe Super Sampling Scaling at 1080p. The performance was even worse than I thought, with significant stuttering making the game virtually unplayable. But something that caught my attention is the GPU dedicated memory of only 128 MB. I believe that could be the reason for bottlenecking for modern games, and unfortunately the BIOS lacks the option to allocate more memory to GPU, as you can do with other devices. I believe it may be the reason we got that extreme stutter and very poor lowest percentile FPS. Also, frame time is pretty horrible and giving high latency. But now how about we do 3D Mark Timespy test to see how scores are like. So let's go for it. So as you can see, we got into the good category in the high performance mode, but still below the average 3722. And the optimize is even more behind. It really shows how poor the Galaxy Book cooling defect is limiting Intel Ultra 155H. Also, temps here got over 98 degrees for optimized and 107 for high performance. Finally, a 3D Mark Timespy stress test to evaluate performance stability over 20 loops failed in both power modes because it's below the passing percentage. For high performance, it improved quite a lot, but still it didn't pass. And finally, with temperatures soaring once again. Now, measuring the exterior temp, we got a hotspot of 42.3 degrees for optimized, with a median of 39.8 around the middle of keyboard. As for the high performance mode, it's peaking at 44.3 degrees and a median of 41.1. It's even inconvenient to use the keyboard in this state. So in conclusion, to me it seems that the Galaxy Book 4 Pro 360 Ultra design or cooling system is compromising the end user experience. Now, I'm not sure if they could address it with merely a BIOS update or something. I really hope so, but this was only a brief overview of my experience with the Galaxy Book 4 Pro 360. Given these issues, I'll be returning the device back to Samsung, and I'm feeling quite hesitant to consider another Galaxy Book in the future, unless there is a significant redesign focused on better cooling and stable performance. If you experience similar issues with the Galaxy Book 4 or previous models as well, please share your experience in the comment section. Also, in this way, we can encourage Samsung to improve their laptops. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to Techosaur for more honest tech reviews. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.